Hi, I'm Molly Wellman, owner of Japs in Cincinnati, Ohio. Nearly 200 acres, 29 barrel aging warehouses, one legendary still house. Since 1879, the limestone-rich water of Tom Moore Spring has brought life to this valley land and exceptional quality to the spirits born here. 1792 carries the torch of this century-old tradition with flair. Named in honor of the year Kentucky joined the United States, 1792 is distinguished in every way. It doesn't look like other bourbons. It doesn't taste like other bourbons. It doesn't act like other bourbons. Sophisticated and complex, 1792 is designed, bottle and all, to elevate everything it touches, to make the finer things in life all the material trappings of success and the defining moments of triumph just a little finer. Art and science combine to produce a bourbon of substance and style. That's 1792. We'd love to have you come visit us at Japs, where we make cocktails from the 1700s to the 1950s and everything in between. We love to give you the best experience you possibly could get in a cocktail bar. I was very honored last year to win Best Bartender Owner in the nation. It just so happens that Japs was founded in 1879. The same year, Barton's 1792 distillery was also founded. We're gonna make a cocktail, the classic among classic cocktails, the old fashioned. And 1792, with its high rye content, is the perfect choice to make a great old fashioned. The thing about an old fashioned is it needs complexity. I love old fashions. I like to use a sugar cube as opposed to using simple syrup. And I love to use a higher proof bourbon to make an old fashioned. This way, the crystals of the sugar cube suspend themselves within the bourbon. And with the high rye content in this, it balances between the two. It makes it wonderful. We're gonna talk to master distiller Danny Kahn here in just a few minutes and share some cocktails and some stories. How you doing, Danny?
I'm great, thank you. How are you, Molly?
Oh, great, all right. We got some cocktails.
Perfect.
You wanna drink?
I would love to drink.
Cheers.
Cheers, great to be with you.
Great to be with you. That's a cocktail.
Thank you, this is wonderful.
I'm glad you
like saw it. You make it, and I enjoyed it.
Thank you, I'm glad you like it. It's, you know, kind of thing I do.
Yeah, I've heard. You know, I'm a huge fan of the cocktail.
Cool.
And of course, to me, it's mostly about the flavor, but I love the ceremony. I love the way it's made. I love the ingredients that are used. I love the way it looks. I get joy out of that whole process.
You and me both. Yes. This is why we could drink properly together.
Yes, yes. And you did a masterful job, so cheers once again.
Thank you very much. Cheers. I'm really particular about the ingredients that go into a good cocktail.
Yeah, so speaking of which, what kind of bourbon would you use?
I used this like really cool bourbon called 1792. Have you heard of it?
I know a little bit about it, yes, yes. I I actually think 1792 is an incredible bourbon for cocktails.
I have to agree with you there.
And my view of that is we make a high rye bourbon.
Yeah.
And I think that the rye complements the components that go into the type of cocktails that I like. I like the spirit-forward cocktail. In this case, I like a bourbon-forward cocktail. I think the rye, because it is a little spicy, a little nutty, very pronounced flavors along with the other bourbon notes. But I think that that works well with a little bit of sweetness, yep. Not too much, a little bit of citrus here, a little bit of bitters. And I just think it a high rye is really where it's at for a cocktail like the one you made.
I have to agree with you. There's something that would be said about being able to work with different flavors and complexities of flavors. That way you can, what you add to the cocktail, you can really start to bring out what flavors you want to bring out and add other things to kind of cover up the flavors that you don't want to bring out.
Yes.
And having that complexity, especially in a bourbon like 1792, is really easy to
awesome,
do.
Awesome. Let me share a little bit about the distillery.
Please do. You know something about this distillery?
I know a little bit about the distillery. It's been around since the late 1800s.
Oh, okay.
So we have a history here. And the equipment that I'm using to distill today, a lot of the building, a lot of our components have been around since the 40s. Because we've been around for so long and because we've got these old fermenters, we have developed a little bit of our own house flavor.
Yeah.
And I think we can see that in many, many ways.
What I find really great about 1792 is the different expressions that
you have
that I get to work with every day. I think
yes.
it's really cool. So
yes,
tell me all good. About that.
Good question. So small batch is the majority of what we make, and there is no clear definition of a small batch, but it's a relatively small batch. We blend some barrels together, we package them. But in addition to small batch, we have single barrel, and we have our single barrel program that anybody can buy, but then also the lucky few can occasionally pick a barrel. We have our bottled and bond, which by definition means that it bottled and bond is a law of 1897 and the first consumer protection law ever.
Yes.
And it says that it has to be 100 proof, it has to be at least 4 years in the barrel, and it has to be all from the same season, meaning we make it, we cook and distill it in one season. That has a lot to do with traceability, just to make sure they know where it came from.
Exactly.
Ours is much, much older in 4 years, but that's the requirement.
Right.
It has less of the spice and the nuttiness and the cinnamon that's associated with rye. And you get a little bit of that biscuity note, but you also get a lot more of the fermentation and aging characters that are normally sort of hidden behind the rye. Rye is so powerful that it can kind of hide some flavors.
Yes.
But they work well together. They're just not as obvious to see.
Right.
And the lucky few get our age 12 year. We released a 12 year old bourbon last year for the first time, and there's not a lot of that, but it's pretty special.
There's something for everyone, you know?
Yes.
There's something for every kind of cocktail,
yes.
even too.
Yes. So let me do this. One that we didn't talk about, which is special for many reasons,
yes.
is our foolproof.
You're speaking my language right
All
now.
Right.
Tell me a little bit about foolproof.
All right, foolproof. So foolproof is bottled at 125 proof.
Nice.
And that is the entry proof. And that means that is the proof that we fill our barrels at.
Perfect.
So in the bourbon aging process, we'll put it in 125 proof, and over time, based on temperature, based on where in the rickhouse it is, whether it's at a lower level where it's cooler, a higher level where it's warmer, what the humidity is, we will lose alcohol and water.
Yes.
But generally, we lose more water, so the proof goes up over time.
Isn't that called the angel share?
Yes,
yes.
It is absolutely the angel share.
We have to keep the angels happy, right?
Absolutely. they protect us, and they make our bourbon
yes.
age properly, so that's all good. So we will dilute it back down, so it's not barrel strength. It could be anywhere from 130 to almost 150 proof, depending
wow.
on how long and where it's stored.
Yeah.
So full proof represents the proof that we put it in the barrel at. So it's a very robust bourbon, and there's a couple other things that make it special. So first of all, yes, enjoy the color.
Yeah, it's beautiful.
You know, I think that the visual impression of our bourbons, all bourbons, but this one in particular is just deep and rich, and you know, I have an expectation of what the flavor will be by looking at it.
I'm getting a lot of those stone fruits as well, and I'm getting the toffee, like toffee candy,
yeah.
some sweetness on it. It's very complex, it's very lovely.
You get a little, the rye comes through.
Yes, it
does. So the fact that this is a little bigger, the rye mixes with those other flavors in
yes.
a very nice balanced marriage of flavor.
I gotta say, I can already tell this would make the most perfect Manhattan.
It would be incredible.
It really would, just everything about it. You could easily bring out a lot of these natural flavors just by adding one or two little, you know, just some perfect vermouth.
Yes.
You know, the right kind of bitters.
Yes.
Just lightly stirred.
I was gonna ask, what would you do with this?
There's no question it would be a Manhattan. Or, you know, there's another cocktail I would love to make with this, Carter, remember the main to bring out those cherry notes, because I'm getting a lot of cherry off of this. It's really important for, you know, you be able to taste the main,
yes,
the main spirit, the main ingredient, and having a special bourbon, especially a foolproof, just like the 1792. It will make it very special.
This, and what's really cool too about this bourbon, I'm sure people come to Japs to also order whiskey, bourbon,
oh, yeah,
neat.
Definitely.
And this is versatile, because ordering it neat is nothing wrong with that. It's wonderful.
It's wonderful. When I go to bars most of the time, if I'm not doing a cocktail, I always look at the bourbon selection and make sure I get something neat.
Yeah, yeah. You know? Yeah, and you know, we're not the only ones that I think really appreciate this, because you may or may not know this, but Jim Murray, who is a really world-renowned whiskey connoisseur, whiskey writer, whiskey judge, not just bourbon, but bourbon, scotch, Irish, American whiskey, etc.
Yes.
He gave this the coveted award of 2020 World Whiskey Winner. So it is considered to be the best whiskey in the world, not in the category of bourbon, but overall whiskey.
Wow.
So we are incredibly appreciative and humbled of that award.
It's incredible. Special. I can see where he's coming from. I mean, my goodness, this is wonderful.
It's got a lot going on.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
It's wonderful.
Yes, thank you. Appreciate that. So one of the things, and this is really not as much a part of making bourbon, but it's really important how it gets to the consumers,
yeah,
and how it gets to the bartenders. And we've done some pretty cool things as a 1792 group. We have reached out to bartenders, and
thank
we've
you.
Yes. Well, thank you. and I mean, really, what's good for you is good for us. And some of the questions, you know, how do we make it better? And some of the things that came up were a longer neck,
yeah,
so that you can grab it quicker, pour it, and then put it back in a smooth fashion. And also, does it fit properly in the bar trays or
on the back of the bar,
you guys call them?
Oh,
so we've
cool.
got a 1 liter bottle coming out.
That's
got
wonderful.
A long neck, and it's a little sort of squattier than this.
I love it.
And it looks cool. And that's based on feedback. So we feel that this relationship, you know, us the distiller and the bartenders, is pretty special. So thank you for that.
Thank you.
And we're excited about this bottle. It'll be coming out soon.
I'm really excited about this
very
bottle.
Cool.
You know, being a bartender, you know, when you're in the weeds, and you know, it's like a dance,
yes,
you know? Good bartenders, they don't even have to look. They already know where it is. If it's easy to grab and pour and put back, that
sure.
is everything.
Yes.
And being a bar owner, I appreciate having, you know, a bottle that will fit nicely on the back of the bar.
Yes.
It's limited space back there sometimes.
Yes, and it's getting crowded, more
yes.
crowded all the time, it appears.
It really is. It really is.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for listening to us. That means everything.
Yeah.
It really does.
Well, we're excited about it too. So keep your eyes open. It's coming.
I'll be there. Right. I can't wait.
Yes.
So I really wish we could have been meeting at Tails this year, but
yeah.
being at Barton's 1792 Distillery, surrounded by all this incredible whiskey, is just as good.
I enjoyed it. Maybe next year. Maybe we can do Tails next year.
I like
Let's hope
that.
For it.
Let's make a point.
Cheers.
All right. Cheers.